A very warm welcome to our coverage of the AFC Asian Cup. It is match day three in Group D, Japan versus Indonesia. We are at the Altamama Stadium in Doha to see if Japan can progress through to the knockout stage of the Asian Cup for the eighth time in a row, and to see if Indonesia can make a little bit of history by progressing for the very first time in a row. Vietnam and Iraq are also involved in the other game of the day. Vietnam already eliminated. The Altamama Stadium, a beautiful venue, 28 degrees. It's a lovely, balmy day. Little bit humid, a little bit of crosswind, but the sun is shining. But the pitch is in beautiful shade, and as usual, looks in magnificent condition. FIFA ranked number 17, Japan meeting Indonesia on the international football stage for the first time this century. Indeed, for the first time since 1989. The prize on offer for both is progression to the knockout stage of the AFC Asian Cup 2023. For Indonesia, that would represent an historic performance for a nation that, despite having a football-obsessed population, have a national team ranked a lowly 146 in the FIFA rankings. For Japan, progression, the very minimum expectation for a nation who've made the knockout stage of this competition on every occasion since 1988. That's eight in a row. Des Corkill in the commentary box for an exciting occasion. Rhys Roshanrai alongside me, normally based in Southeast Asia. Rosh, so quite exciting for Indonesia to have a chance of making a little bit of history.
Incredibly exciting for Indonesia. This is a big game for both sides, and for Japan as well coming into this one. How often do you say this? Japan at the risk of elimination from the group stage at an AFC Asian Cup. Everyone was expecting them to breeze through the competition, to go on and be the winners of it at the end. But they just haven't quite been themselves. They weren't that convincing in their win against Vietnam.
Is it a case that they peaked too early? Because those wins against Germany earlier on this year and Turkey, we talk about teams peaking for competitions. They were just so good. Everyone was saying nobody can stop them, but they stuttered against Vietnam, as you said, and they were well beaten by Iraq.
They were. But I think they had some opportunities in that one, but their shooting was all over the place. Didn't manage many shots on target at all in that fixture against Iraq. And you need to get those results across the line. Whether it's a bit of complacency, the fact that they've come into this in such a great run of form, that they themselves think this was going to be straightforward, at least in the group stages. It's been a bit of a surprise the way the other sides have come out and performed against them. But you expect a response here, a real response. We'll go with the lineups a little bit later on, but Moriyasu, I don't think, has been too happy with what he's seen from his side so far. What an opportunity for Indonesia as well to create history.
This is the AFC Asian Cup at the Altamama Stadium in Doha. It is match day three of the group stages. A stuttering Japan, we're not used to saying that, against an Indonesia side who have nothing to lose, and a nation to actually get adulation from if they can get through to the next stages. We'll give you the team lineups after the respective national anthems.
Standing for the national anthem of Indonesia. والآن يرجى مواصلة الوقوف لعزف النشيد الوطني لإندونيسيا.
deafening rendition of Indonesia Raya rings around the Al-Jumama Stadium. Opportunity knocks for Indonesia. History can be made. And forgive us if in the early stages we focus on Indonesia and their passion. But for Japan, 8 changes from coach Moriyasu. He often does this in the big internationals, but he hasn't changed his goalkeeper. Dion Suzuki has come under a lot of pressure. A whole new back four, Maikama, Tomiyasu, Machida and Nakayama have yet to start so far this tournament. Into midfield, Hatate comes in to partner Watoru Endo, who scored against Iraq late on. And up front, it's all changed as well. Nakamura down the left-hand side. Ritsi Doan, the tricky little right-sided player, they'll play alongside Kubo. Ayasi up front will try to add to his 8 international goals. We're anticipating a 4-2-3-1 on the bench. Plenty of goals should Japan require them. Ito and Minamino between them have got 33 international strikes. Match official for this contest is Kamis Almari, 39-year-old Qatari. He's been a FIFA referee since 2010. This is his second Asian Cup. 20 yellow cards dished out in his last 8 matches. He does like to keep his card in his pocket. As usual, in all the matches in the 2023 Asian Cup Qatar, there is VAR support, and Salman Ahmed Palahi from Qatar, Mohammed Taki from Singapore are the men with responsibility in the VAR room. Indonesia, Shin Tae-yong has got an average age of 22 years and 7 months for this starting 11. Hernando has been with him at under 20 and now under 23 and senior level in goal. Sandy Walsh's experience, the Mechelen centre-back, comes in alongside Jordi Amat and Rizky Rido, who plays in the domestic league. It's youth in midfield with Ivar Jenner, 19-year-old for Utrecht, partnering Justin Hubner, a 20-year-old who plays for Wolves in England. Marcelino, an outstanding prospect on the left-hand side of a front three, if they possibly can. Ege Mulana plays domestically at Dewa United. On the substitute bench, Elton Baggett plies his trade in the United Kingdom. Aznawi is a very useful player and he scored the goal that's helped beat Vietnam. Let's focus on Indonesia, Reece Roshan Rai, because that is the fairy tale, potentially.
Yeah, it is. I've been really impressed with how they've approached this competition. It's not a case of them just looking to sit back and try and hit on the counter. At times they've stepped up, they've challenged for a possession. They try and put the opposition sides under pressure. Massive win against Vietnam, which gives them this platform here to go on and progress into the next stage of the competition. What a story it would be if they could do that.
Indonesia would go berserk if they could create history. The countdown is on to kick off. 4, 3, 2, 1. Match day 3 of the AFC Asian Cup group stage is underway. And immediately Japan in the blue and white, going left to right, launch the ball. 8 changes of personnel for Japan from the starting team that started against Iraq. But it may be 8 change of personnel. It certainly doesn't diminish the quality in their starting lineup. Reece Roshan Rai alongside me in the commentary box. It's quality everywhere you look along this Japan starting 11.
Well, that's what he's been blessed with, Hajime Moriyasu. A very talented squad, very talented lineup. He can chop and change. He's obviously not been too happy with the performances so far. I don't think they were at their best in their opening match. Certainly weren't at their best against Iraq, just lacking that little bit of guile, a little bit of creativity at times, which is strange to say, but also defensively, that's where it's been a real issue for them. I don't think they've defended the channels very well, and they seem to struggle with the physicality, especially against Iraq in that second match, and trying to manage those set-piece situations. So he will know the pressure is on, and he'll be hoping that his players can deliver.
Moriyasu's 76th game in charge of Japan. Japan had only ever, before the defeat to Iraq, suffered one defeat in the group stage of an AFC Asian Cup. Offside there, over on this near side against Jakub Sayuri. Actually, Jakub Sayuri starts on the left-hand side today. Normally, he's operating down the right-hand side as a wing-back. One or two change of personnel.
Yeah, it's an interesting one. I expected Jakub Sayuri to be playing on the right, bombing forward from that position, but they swapped it around just to give themselves something different. Going with the 5-4-1 here.
Ritu, lovely slide pass into Ueda. That's interesting. Ueda, very, very tight was Jordi Amat. The Johor Darrell attacks him. He got a little bit too close. Shin Tae-yong looks really cool. He was really calm in his pre-match interview, putting no pressure on his players, Rosh.
Well, he's incredibly experienced. I'm concerned that there might be a bit of holding here from Amat. He's way too tight. Way too tight. I think the referee might just get a bit of a note from the VAR here to possibly have a closer look at that. You can see his arms wrapped around the attacker. He's concerned. I think he knows he was caught too tight. He was spun. It would have been in behind. Could be trouble early on for Indonesia.
Well, we've had VAR intervention several times, but none this early. Jordi Amat's got very, very tight to Tueda. And your thoughts immediately, I saw you raise an eyebrow that this is a possibility. It's a long check, and that is always a worrying sign. Referee edging towards this area, and he's been brought over towards the video screen. And this is potentially a catastrophic start for Indonesia.
Big problem for them here. You come into these matches, and you've got that game plan in mind to try and frustrate the opposition. You don't want to give these opportunities away. You know you're going to be up against it. That's holding. That's holding, isn't it? I mean, you look at that. He's got his arms wrapped around him. He's turned away. Ueda, he's gotten far too tight. Needs to keep a little bit of distance there. Just needs to make sure that Ueda can't turn him. He's caught wrong side. He pulls him down. I think this is going to be a pen.
The decision is penalty early on. Jordi Amat says, what am I meant to do? Well, for Jordi, he was holding, the arms were wrapped around. And for Indonesia, the worst possible start.
It's clear. I mean, I don't think there's a real argument against it. He's caught out of position. It's clear-cut holding. It's a clear-cut foul. And he's trying his best to talk to the referee. But the decision's been made. It is the right call. Absolutely the right call. Great use of the technology.
Hernando Ari has an opportunity to make himself a national hero. Ayesi Ueda, 8 international goals for the final striker. It'll be a yellow card for Jordi Amat as well.
Indonesia fans just behind the goal, doing their best just to try and throw him off. The noise is deafening. Incredible atmosphere here.
As he plays in Rotterdam, though, he's used to this, and that is laser focus. Early chance for Japan to get off to a confidence-boosting start. Top corner, it's a fine finish. Japan have a lead inside 6 minutes.
Great penalty, really well taken by Ayase Ueda. No chance for the goalkeeper. He goes the right way as well. It's a good attempt from Hernando. It's really well struck, well put away. You either go really high or you go really low. Not quite into the top corner, but enough just to get it away from Hernando.
Indonesia have to start again. They've got 3 points, so there is still a chance of third best in the table, even with defeat here, but there's other games to play tomorrow. And the only way they can guarantee their place for a little bit of history is with a victory. That was a long stretch at the start of the game. It's even further away now. Makuma's long throw. Ritsudon beaten to the punch. Hubner plays it down the line.
Well, that goal is going to help settle the nerves for Japan. Also means that Indonesia are going to have to change their approach very quickly here and have to push players forward a bit more. They've got a nice weapon in the form of Arhan and his ability with his long throws.
It's a long apron as well. Rafael Struik, the Den Haag striker, trying to make a nuisance of himself. Defended by Machida on the edge of the penalty area. And chasing there is Jenner.
Well, we're looking at those areas, Indonesia. There's an opportunity to put the pressure on Japan.
Jordi Amat's header. Spectacular intervention coming in there from Sandy Walsh. Many ways going a goal down so early on. You've just got to put it out of your mind, Rosh. It's very difficult to do so, but you've got to.
Well, you've got to try and sort of just get on with it. Obviously, it does change the flow of the game and the momentum of it. You know in the back of your mind that there's going to have to be a switch in your approach at some point. Without the ball, when you don't have it, yes, you can try and sit back in these areas and make sure you don't concede again. But when you get it, then you have to be a little bit more expansive, take a few more chances. And Japan are in that position now where they can sort of wait and be patient with the opportunities and with the chance creation. Unless they play themselves into trouble like that, because Indonesia will look to try and hit into the channels and the spaces that will be afforded to them out wide when Japan's fullbacks push on.
Kubo dropping deep. He's one of only three players retaining their place. Kubo and Suzuki and Wataru Endo in the heart of midfield. There is Endo. Tomiyasu, long and a little bit aimless, and a first real touch of the ball for Anando Ari. Persebaya Surabaya goalkeeper, 21 years of age. 22 and a half average age for Indonesia. He's done great things with under 20, under 23, and national team as Shin Tae-yong. Trying to play striking. Kubo slides it round the corner. That time, Jordi Amat, safety first. Suzuki, 21-year-old goalkeeper, talking of youth for Japan. I think the choice of staying with Suzuki from Coach Moriyasu is a vote of confidence in a goalkeeper who was under a little bit of pressure.
Well, that's right. I think it is also a reflection of the faith that he has in him. I think it's down to the player to show that he can repay that trust. I think it's smart from Moriyasu. You know, you don't want to destroy the confidence of a 21-year-old goalkeeper in Suzuki. And also, I don't think it's just him. Yes, there have been some issues with his individual play, but overall, as a team, they're defending at times has been quite poor, Japan. And I think he's shown that with his selection here, making all those changes. And I don't think he was quite happy with how much of a protection Zion Suzuki was actually getting. Just not enough. Teams were able to play through pretty easily.
Justin Hubner was beaten to the punch there. Arham has to cover. This is Mike Kuma. Tomiyasu. Into space by Kubo. The blonde-haired Nakamura is just caught offside. Nakamura on the far side. 6 goals in 6 starts for the French-based winger. Good call by the assistant referee.
Well, I think we've been tricked a little bit by their initial lineup and the setup. Tactical setup that we thought they were going to be playing with, that we were given. Instead, what's happened is you've actually got Sandy Walsh playing as that right wing back, but don't expect him to get forward too much. And then what they've done in central midfield is instead of Hübner playing alongside Jenner, which is what we were told, he's actually dropped into that back line. Rizky Rido on the right-hand side of Jordi Amat, so they've got a solid bank of five in there, paying a lot of respect to the quality that Japan have.
Clever from Kubo. Good to throw in off Aha. He's got a lot of versatility to play with as Shin Tae-yong. Plenty of friendlies before this tournament, but a couple of big defeats against Iran and Libya. Endo. Amat. Mitsunoan's first touch was beautiful. Kubo. Nipped offside, but I think it came off an Indonesian player. Hübner does well. Strike. Very, very deep. He was the furthest Indonesian player forward. Atate gets in the effort that goes harmlessly wide.
Under pressure here early on. And sort of game that you expect. Sort of flow that you'd expect. It's been great watching the rise of Indonesian football over the last few years or so. Real push for the mixed heritage players to come in, but also their local players. I think it's really worth mentioning that they've taken the step up. They've tried to test themselves in higher level leagues, the likes of Arhan and Asnawi, going to play in Korea Republic, going to play in Japan. And you have Marcelino Ferdinand, who's moved to Belgium as well. And then the likes of Witan Sulaiman, Egi Maulana, players who've got that experience of having spent some time developing in Europe. So you have a look at this clear foul.
Sandy Walsh on the back of Ueda, who won the penalty in a similar style. Japan have started well, pinging the ball about. There's a common belief if Indonesia ever get it right, the population. It's such a football mad society.
Absolutely. I feel like growing up in Southeast Asia, watching a lot of Southeast Asian football, a lot of Asian football, there's always been this discussion about Indonesia.
Cleared by Hübner. 20-year-old Wolves player. There's Ritudoan. Goes around the outside of Rizky. Pulls into the back post. Egi Maulana. Much happier going forward than he is in that kind of right back position.
Yeah, having to do a job here. He's trying to, Shin Tae-yong is find that balance of having enough bodies at the back to protect themselves, especially in the wider areas with the quality that Japan have. And then also being able to have that profile on the pitch to, when they do have it, try and cause issues in attack.
Atate just trying to slide it through. Akiyama. Endo. Just a little bit too much on that for Nakamura to chase.
Dominating possession. And just going back quickly to Indonesia. And we've always, for years and years and years now, spoken about the potential of that nation. A wonderful footballing country. Lots of good players that they produce over the years, but they somehow have not been able to sort of translate that into real success on the international stage at a high level. We're starting to see them do that now with the help of the mixed heritage players. But as I've also said, the development of some of the local talent, exposing themselves to a better footballing education. And it's so important that as they grow with this senior team, that they don't forget the development channels and the pathways.
Allowed to run a long way there. There's Nakayama, Atate. And to pick out Endo, there's a hand. Free kick for Japan. We've absolutely bossed possession. Oh, it's not a hand, it's off the referee. Kamisal Mari in the middle of things. 14 years he's been on the FIFA list and he's only 39. They start them young.
Identify here. Talented referees, give them a long runway.
Semai Kuma. Kubo. be given license to float into little spaces. Lovely reverse pass by Kubo. Ueda doesn't break for Nakamura. And Sandy Walsh can clear.
Doing just about enough there, the Indonesian defence. Risky Rido just getting a toe in. And eventually being able to clear their lines. Clever play from Kubo.
Do you pick Kubo up man-to-man when he goes into midfield, or...? It's
so difficult, because how do you go... If you pick man-to-man, he'll just drag you across somewhere else, and that leaves a space open for another player. There's so much talent in this Japan side, and you can talk tactical theory all you want. It's games played out there on the pitch. It's about the quality you have out there, whether players can focus in their zones, whether they can pass the player on. It's always a challenge to deal with opposition attackers who are given a license to roam freely.
Flick from Ritsu. There's Ueda. Kubo out wide. Ritsu inside of him. There is Ritsu Doan. He's strong enough to retain possession. Possessional stats in this opening 19 minutes, heavily in favour of the Blue Samurai. Nakamura. Pass and move, give and go. Nakamura loses out but retains possession. Hatate, a little give and go. And then a little bit too much on that for Ueda, for Nakayama, and it's a respite for Indonesia.
Not seen much of the ball in Indonesia here. Having to just hang on under this intense pressure. Great start from Japan. This is a lot more like it. Moving the ball along very quickly now, playing in between the lines, especially in behind Indonesia's midfield. And the concern for Shin Tae-yong here is that Japan are able to break through right through the middle.
Notable then, when there was a miscontrol from Maekuma, no Indonesian player was even remotely interested in pushing forward.
You just have a look at Japan's setup. Nice shot here. You've got Endo just in front of a back three in possession when they build up. And then you have Ayase Ueda. You've also got Hatate. Kubo all in that space in behind Indonesia's midfield.
Nakayama doing really well. Fullback. Coming in many ways, this seems to be a more balanced 11 than the 11 that started against Iraq. Very different opponent, of course.
Yeah.
Little dink over the top. It's above Jordi Amat and just skips off the turf away from Ueda. And then Stroik, if he goes for that, is offside.
I just want to end this pause, just give you, if you're watching on, an idea as to what it's like if you're Indonesia playing against a side like Japan. Hey, he's well off. There's no argument about that. That's really poor. You know, you think that you've blocked off the passing lane. You think you've blocked off the channel into the player behind you. And then suddenly it just goes over your head, just like that. With perfect weight, perfect time of pass, of movement. It's just a completely different level to what you're normally up against.
And the Japanese players seem to spin off, come short, spin off.
It's the movement of the ball. It's just the pace of play. It's quicker than what you're normally used to. The technique, the one and two touch play, the movement of the ball. That's where a lot of the differences are.
Walsh the target, but way off target. The pass from Justin Hubner. 20-year-old from Wolves, winning his sixth international cap. But a lot of them have come in the last few months in the Asian Cup and the build-up to it. Indonesia play in their regional championship, the ASEAN Federation Championship, and have four-time been runners-up in that, so they're big weights in ASEAN.
Here they go again. man with this setup. Ayase Ueda trying to position himself in between Ahmad and Hubner. Of course, he's got that license to just drop off as well, but at times he just looked to try and pin those central defenders. Good run. This from Kubo.
Kubo's looking very mobile today. Japan invariably win the ball back quickly. Takahiro Tomiyasu. The Arsenal defender finds Ritsu Doan. He does one of those little chip balls that Jordi Amat this time can pick up. Ferdinand. Pressure is on. Sandy Walsh is dispossessed. And that is the fullback. That's Kubo. Tate leaves it, little give and go. And where's the out ball for Indonesia? How do they relieve this pressure?
Oh, fantastic from Japan. Brilliant counter-pressing.
Ueda leaves it. Kubo out wide. Kubo across the face of goal, away from the outstretched foot of Ayase Ueda.
Just brilliant from Japan, the way they counter-press this. The moment they lose it, said Indonesia looking for that out ball. They're being squeezed so quickly. Maikuma steps up, takes it off Indonesia, and then Japan can attack once more.
Even from their own possession, that's dangerous. Walsh comes away with the ball, sorry, Jordi Amat comes away with the ball. Tries to get the ball up front. A high-pitched jeer as Indonesia at last have some possession. But Suzuki is able just to hold things off from Egy Maulana. Nakamura. Iraq top of this group with 6 points, Japan and Indonesia 3 apiece. Indonesia a minus one goal difference.
I always say in these situations when you're coming up against side with higher quality, you are playing at your maximum, at top gear, whereas for them, they can vary it. They can go through the gears as and when they need to.
There's Kubo. Sayori went with him that time. Egy Maulana. Again, has to do work defensively, only finds a blue shirt. Indonesia must feel there's 20 blue shirts out there. They may have made 8 changes, but they didn't take the other 8 off the pitch.
You just see them here again, just slowing it down, playing at their pace, and then when it comes into these areas, they'll try and move it along very quickly if they can. They've got that ability to change it up. It's a change of pace. It's a change of tempo that really does the damage. Surrounded by red shirts, 4 of them. Atate still able to squeeze his way through and win a free kick.
Rafael Struck with the errant foul. Good use of the super slow-mo from the prostrate Rio Hatate. Long way out for a shot. 4-man ball. Tate goes short. Looking from Ritsu Doan. Not the best ball in. Walsh. Second touch literally was a tackle there for Sandy Walsh. And a little tug back. Referee will have a word, I feel, with Yuta Nakayama.
Very smart with how they do that as well. And if they can't win it, just look to try and commit a foul. Not too serious one. Just get themselves back behind the ball.
Wow. Sayori, our fan, sorry, was saying, I'm not 17 foot tall. Endo. Up to date with the other match going on simultaneously, but already Iraq are through and Vietnam are out. this is the one that can decide if there's extra progression to the knockout stage. And a misunderstanding going forward on the rare time they've had the ball in the opposition third. Marcelino Ferdinand with a misplaced pass.
Well, that looked promising. You just see Shin Tae-yong as well, encouraging his side not to drop off. Wants them to stay high here from this goal kick as Japan try to play it short. Wants them to push up. But a bit of encouragement there. But those are the areas where Indonesia have just got to do a little bit better in terms of their own quality in possession. Simple, straightforward passes. Can't allow themselves to get sloppy with the with those situations. We're not going to see much of the ball. When they do have it, they need to be very efficient, very effective, the little possession that they'll have. Well, having said that, their first two games, they've been pretty good in terms of creating chances with relative to the amount of ball that they've had.
Iraq 0, Vietnam 0 in the other group game as Risky Riddo decides no risk required. Football for Persija Jakarta, and for the second time it's not even close. You can see the idea is a decent idea, but it's completely overhit twice in a row.
Yeah, it is. I think at times in those situations perhaps he's been told to look for those diagonals, but I'm not quite sure that the diagonal is actually on there. Could have played a short pass into Jenner in central midfield, who actually had a bit of space to work with. And then just try and hang on to it. You don't always have to rush in these situations to get the ball forward.
As you said, the diagonal's not on, but the short ball's not on either. Neither's the ball into the middle. Foul coming in from the goal scorer, Ayesi Ueda. An early penalty gives you the score top left. Japan 1, Indonesia 0.
Possession, Jordi Amat pushing into this midfield role. There's that flexibility of being able to drop in without the ball, step up into defensive midfield with an extra man so they can build up.
That's better to Sandy Walsh. Egy Maulana, good skills from Egy Walsh. Egy did well not to play the ball, then he would have been in an offside position. Chance for Indonesia to maybe just have a little bit of possession. Hubner to the left, Orhan further outside of him, the left wing back. Lovely ball to Marcelino. Marcelino across the face of goal. It's a corner to Indonesia, their best moment by some margin.
Yeah, nice move from their perspective here. Thinking perhaps it's starting to just grow into the game. Definitely the confidence in possession. So much better. Keeping it on the ground with the link up. Working opening down the left. Marcelino Ferdinand. I wonder if there was an option available to him on the cutback. Did see Jenner just making a move towards the top of the penalty area.
First corner of the match. Amat is up there. Walsh is in that ruck of players. Strikers on the line. Hubner's joined the party. And it hits the side netting at the front post. It causes a squeal of excitement, but it's a wasted corner.
I don't know. Does he mean this? There's another look at that. He couldn't quite get his body around the ball. Just trying to squeeze it into an area where he didn't really have options. Could actually work his way around the ball. Perhaps the cutback would have been a better option. I'll go with the left foot there for the cutback. He's pretty adamant that he wanted to play it with his right. Marcelino Ferdinand, who's an incredibly talented player. It's been great to see his development as well as an individual over the last few years or so. It gives them something special from midfield.
One of two teenagers in the starting lineup. Six players under 23. Even if there is elimination, and that's not what they want, but even if they go out early, just think of the experience these players have gleaned from this competition.
future that definitely looks very bright for Indonesia.
Atate went down under the slightest bit of pressure from Rizky Ridho.
It's well defended, really well defended by Rizky Ridho. Kept pace with Atate. Tried to get away from him on the turn. Slight arm across, but the way Atate goes down, it's exaggerated, the contact. We expect defenders in those situations to always have your arm across. Attackers will do the same. It's a normal football contact, it's a normal football movement.
Strike hoisted forward. Youngster who's with the Den Haag club in the Netherlands. 10th international start for Rafael Struijk, but he's not seen much of the ball so far. But it is a decent response from Indonesia. They haven't caved in.
Yeah, that's right. But it took a bit of time for them to settle. Now you want to see a little bit more of this from Indonesia, using these opportunities to press and put Japan under pressure, not making it so easy for them, not showing them too much respect.
Peggy's flick forward. Jakob Sayori was just trying to get in there. Ritsu, such quick feet, as has Kubo. And look at that, in an instant there's an attack. Atate feeds Nakamura. Nakamura's got players running inside. Nakayama decides to come out to Atate. Kubo, lovely dink over the top for Nakamura. Nakamura blocked to the edge of the penalty area. Kubo denied by heroic work from Egi Maulana. Kubo again. It's pulled back and put onto the post by Nakamura. A sweet move by Japan that deserved a goal. Is denied by a post and somehow stays out.
Absolutely brilliant. And how often are Japan doing this? Where they have these lofted chipped balls over the top, over that defensive line. So unlucky. Nakamura is going for the control finish, looking to pass it in to goal. But you just saw twice there in quick succession that example of what I was talking about earlier. You think you're blocking the passing lanes, the channels with the balls on the turf, but then you forget that these guys have the quality to just play these little chip passes over the top.
Can't afford to do that, Indonesia, giving the ball away far too easily. Nakamura goes down under a bit of pressure. And look at that, Tomiyasu is there ahead of Rafael Struijk.
Great movement from Japan, perfect way to pass as well. Throw balls over the top. In behind that Indonesian back line. Brilliant stuff. It was a move that deserved a goal. After an encouraging spell for Indonesia, Japan just once again reminding everyone of their class in case you forgot.
Maikuma. That's a bit naughty from our hand. Kubo didn't like that. Kubo. Well, if Arhan wasn't going to get him, Jakob Sayuri was.
Well, Arhan this time around, I think, makes sure Kubo feels the full force of that. And Endo's gone up to the referee to say there was a challenge earlier as well on Kubo from Arhan. Here's another look at this. Beautiful. Just beautiful. Through the legs. Coming so close. Getting the second. Oh, he's another Nakamura. Such an exciting talent. Doing well for himself in Europe.
Atate is the right foot, he's 17. Hoiks it in. pushed away rather uncomfortably by Anandawari. On the other end, Suzuki, who's had a very quiet time of it today. That's Waterloo Endo. Ritsu so busy in the heart of midfield, isn't he? Yes. Ian Kubo
dropping off, rotating, changing positions, trying to link the play.
Nakamura looks for Ritsu Doan, a little bit too high. They had a run, did Japan in the middle of 2023, Germany 4-2, and Peru were beaten by 4. Turkey conceded 4, and then it got to the World Cup and they went up to 5, so they just couldn't stop scoring goals. Then Iraq came along.
The form that they were in Japan, tempted to say that they were going to win the next World Cup, the way that they've been playing, the way that they've been developing, the quality that they have, players that they can call upon.
Nakamura in ahead of Risky. Ferdinand gets the header in, Tomiyasu hoists it over the top and says to Nakamura, you go and chase that. And Ando had to have a clear call there to make sure Sandy Walsh and he didn't collide. Akiyama comes forward for Japan, slows it down to Hatate.
That variation, the tempo of their game, slow it down, get players into the right positions, don't have to rush, make sure everything's set.
Akiyama, first corner of the match for Japan.
By slowing it down as well, they're also saying to Indonesia, come on and press, we want the spaces to open up so we can play through. Indonesia at the moment, keen on opening up. Quite happy just to take their time.
Ritsu wants it short. Indonesia could be a man short if it is played to Ritsu. Instead, they're going to go to the four men they've got in the penalty area. Well met by Justin Hubner. Solid header. Up to the 40th minute, Japan 1, Indonesia 0. Japan scoring early from the penalty spot from Ayase Ueda.
That's good, that's good from a strike, gives away a free kick, but the intent is what I'm applauding, trying to close down as there was a foul to the back of Tomiyasu.
He's still down, is Tomiyasu.
Just recent weeks coming back from injury, I think, Tomiyasu.
Yes. Hobbles away. Legions of Arsenal fans around the world won't be too thrilled to see that.
Yeah, I'm more concerned about the Japan fans.
Stand admonished, Stan Ueda. He was admonished going through. Struck. It's being a little bit physical, Rafael Struck, and there's going to be a telling off here at the very least. It could be a card because he's not got his eye on the ball. It is indeed a yellow card, and I think that's fully justified for Rafael Struck.
Yeah, especially his two fouls in quick succession. So a very young player, he's not looking at the ball at all. He's just got one thing on his mind, which is to jump into Maekuma. So you can understand why Japan weren't happy with that challenge.
He went in like a man possessed.
He's not
yellow
had
card.
Not had much of an opportunity to actually get involved in the game in an attacking sense, perhaps a bit of frustration as well.
Tate. Ferdinand. Up forward by Walsh. Schwab is chasing. Eddie Milana on the back of Endo. Just how competently free-flowing is the movement. Our keeper's out to the edge of his penalty area. Hubner. Good pace from the young Wolvesman.
It's really difficult for Indonesia. They're constantly getting possession confiscated by Japan. Great run on the inside channel as well from Ayase Ueda. Good goalkeeping from Hernando. Quick off his line, nice and positive.
Walsh close in on Kubo. Just finds a lovely angle to play it back. Escape Rido clears. Indonesia's Garuda fans are trying to lift their team behind the goal in which they are defending. Kubo glides into space. Once again, it's the fullback Mike Kuma who's getting the decisive knock on the far post. And Jordi Amat pleased to clear.
Nice work getting around the blind side. Sandy Walsh just struggling playing out there, I think. And the pace of the players he's coming up against, really good run. Because Kubo played it across, made that run. I think he'll be pretty pleased with what he's seen so far, Moriyasu.
Every time we go to an ISO shot of him, he's applauding. He's liking what his team are doing.
Because I think the attitude has been spot on, the approach has been very good. If you're frustrated at the fact that they're slowing it down, it's with intent. It's with the intent of having got that goal and trying to open up Indonesia, trying to say open up, give us those passing channels. If you're not, we're just going to take our time. But again, know that they can quicken the pace of it.
Interesting corner. Nakamura was the man who was trying to get into that space. Amat beat to it. Atate. Hubner loses out. Amat clears. Struck. This time does well. Machida. And Endo is there. That's a free kick by Wataru Endo. That might have just been a little bit of protecting his players there from Endo.
I think that's exactly what it was. Exactly that. He sees this. An opportunity to come in. To be honest, it's not really too much in that. The chance to just give him a bit of a knock there. Just into the shin.
You kick my boys, I'll protect them.
Yeah.
Old ice hockey enforcer.
And I'll tell you, players on the pitch as well, especially those in leadership roles, they'll come up to you. If someone's been targeting one of their players, they'll go up to their players first of all and say, don't worry about it, I'll get him. I'll get him next. And they'll deliver.
Kubo. Ueda. Looks for Ritsu Doan. We're into 4 minutes of time added on at the end of this first half. And credit to Indonesia. They conceded the penalty early. They survived by the skin of the teeth that shot against the post. But Hernando Ari hasn't been overworked despite all the possession for the Blue Samurai.
Good control of this game, Japan, and again it's broken free in midfield. Lovely pass.
Atate to Tueda. Three in the penalty area. Well recovered, Ivan Jenner. Came back, made a very important contribution there, Jenner.
That's a shame for Japan, just got stuck under the foot of Ayase Ueda. Good movement, great movement from Hatate it was, and the pass into him was excellent, line breaking, right through that midfield, taken out of the equation.
It was like crown green balls, wasn't it? Perfect. Kubo floating inside once again, onto Wataru Endo. Maikuma, takes a blue shirt forward, just lifts it into Kubo. Oh. Kuma. Solid tackle. Good defensive work. Ferdinand has done a really good job there. Oh, and then slips. And Ritsudoa drives into the penalty area and is blocked off. Solid challenge by Justin Hubner.
No, nothing wrong there with Hubner. There's no way he can really go. He's just been run into. Good bit of skill from Doan. Through the legs. But Marcelino Ferdinand was really unlucky. Just loses his footing. But I don't mind that at all, because you need someone at times when you're under that sort of pressure to just hang on to it, keep possession, and then try and find a way forward. It's just a little bit unfortunate that he slipped.
Kubo floats inside again. Nakayama. Indonesia flying the tackles in. That one will be a free kick. Jakub Sayuri. Kubo, though, he's gone inside every time. And from high up here, you can almost see what he's going to do. But he does it so thrillingly.
It's just really intelligent. And it's really smart the way Japan is rotating the positions as well. Kubo will drift out wide, try and find that space, get away from a marker, you play it into him, and then make a run into those central areas. Also got Ritsu Doan, and they can switch positions.
Shooting distance, Hernando Ari. He's only got a two-man wall. Kubo, little dink over the top, and that's too far ahead of Endo. That could be the last action of this first half.
Time around the weight on that the pass over the top, not quite right. Probably a little bit too far to have a direct attempt at goal.
Half time whistle goes. Referee Kamis Almari says enough is enough. Indonesia relieved, happy perhaps to be only 1-0 down. Japan with the early penalty from Ayasi Ueda. He won the penalty after being hauled back by Jody Amat at half-time. It is Japan leading Indonesia by 1-0.
Yeah, I think Japan will be really happy with the way it's gone so far. They would have liked to at least have another goal, I'm sure. Came close with that, but they've been in really good control of this one. Suzuki has not had anything to really do in that first 45. As for Indonesia, I think you want to see a bit more from them in attack in this second half.
1-0 it is at half-time to Japan. A very warm welcome back to the Al Tumama Stadium in Doha. It is AFC Asian Cup 2023. Indonesia versus Japan. Half-time, it is Japan leading by 1-0. An early penalty converted by Eyasio Ueda. It means that Japan, as it stands, are on 6 points. And they have a clear route and a clear view of the round of 16. For Indonesia, they've worked hard, they've tried their very best, but they have been second best as far as the game has gone. Des Korkil in the commentary box, alongside Reece Roshan-Rai, a former professional in Southeast Asia. And Roshan, let's focus on Indonesia first, and how, if at all, they can get something out of this game.
Incredibly difficult. It's been a big challenge for them when they do have it to try and cause problems for Japan, who have been in such good control with their counter-pressing, especially when they lose it, they win it back straight away. Indonesia somehow need to find a little bit of composure in possession. They need to find those connections. They offered nothing in attack in the first half. Zero shots. Nothing at all for Indonesia, and that's the concern here. But of course, when you're up against this quality of opposition, that's perhaps not too much of a surprise. But if they want to stay in this competition, then it needs to be a very special 45 minutes coming up.
Defeat isn't necessarily the end of their dreams, but it would be very unlikely. There's more matches to be played tonight and tomorrow, and they will be third best in the group. Because they won the head-to-head against Vietnam, Vietnam are leading Iraq by 1-0 in the match being played simultaneously. But if Indonesia and Vietnam finish level on points, head-to-head is the deciding factor. So Indonesia would be third in the group, but 3 points might not be enough. Let's see what they can get in this second half. It's just about to get underway. No changes of personnel. It is Indonesia versus Japan. Khamis Almari from Qatar gets us underway. Indonesia going left to right in all Indonesia, in all red. Di Garuda. One crumb of comfort is that it is only a single goal, and football has this funny habit of producing shocks and surprises where you don't expect them.
Yeah, certainly does. I mean, for all of their control, for all of their dominance, for all the chances that they've created, Japan, it's still just 1 goal in it.
Anando Ari decided late to come for that ball, but got there ahead of Ritsu Doan. Tomiyasu's header.
And I think that's one of the things that Shin Tae-yong would have picked up on at halftime, to tell his players, okay, we didn't offer too much going forward, but it's still just 1-0. Long way to go yet in this match.
Mariasu, the Japanese coach, 76 game in charge. He's won 51 of them. It really is remarkable. Japan consistently make it to the latter stages of the FIFA World Cup. They're looking to make it 8 in a row into the knockout stage of the AFC Asian Cup. History is the thing that Korean coach Shin Tae-yong is chasing for. Indonesia. Indonesia have never made it into the knockout stage of the competition. Lovely little drop pass forward, but it's won back by Hubner. Finds Jordi Amat.
That's better from Indonesia. What you saw there was Rizky Ridho actually just stepping forward with Rio Hatate, forcing him into a bad pass, eventually leading to a turnover in possession.
Long from Anando. Picked up by Tomiyasu. Ueda. There's always such good weight on the pass. This is Nakamura. A chance to run at Walsh. Nakayama outside of him, and it hit his own player. And gone out spectacularly off Itate for a goal kick.
Itate on that occasion just becoming the extra man in defence for Indonesia. Painful one as well. Fired into his head. I think he's had a good game, Hatate, in central midfield. He's been very dynamic, shown really good mobility.
Let's run you quickly through the teams. Japan, Suzuki in goal. Maekuma, Mashida, Tomiyasu and Nakayama at the back. Endo and Hatate in the heart of midfield. Ritsudoan, Nakamura providing the width for Kubo and Ueda as the main front two. And that's a poor kick out by Anando Ari, who's in goal for Indonesia. A back three of Rizky Ridho, Jody Amat and Justin Hubner. Sandy Walsh wide right, Jakub Sayori wide left. Arham and Jenner in the heart of midfield. Ferdinand also dropping into midfield. Struck and Egi Maulana, the two front men, when they can get the ball forward, which hasn't been often. Nakamura. Naughty little after kick there by Sandy Walsh.
Yeah, I think that's also something that Shin Tae-yong has probably encouraged a little bit at halftime. Stop showing them so much respect. Get in there, make some contact, let them know they're in a match.
So Kerr's Republic try a similar tactic and ended with nine players the other day.
Obviously, you've got to do it in a smart way. But look at what could potentially come about of it. Again, it was Indonesia stepping in hard with the challenges in midfield, winning it cleanly. And then, when you take it off them, an opportunity to attack.
Jordi Amat just rescuing there as Ueda tried to break forward after good interception by Keito Nakamura.
Yes, that was risky from Risky. Apologies. Go inside, go inside.
There's a yellow card, I think, coming for Shin Tae-yong. I'm not sure which of the officials on the sideline speaks Korean. Although Shin has a smattering of English. I'm not sure about his Arabic.
I think it's the body language. Perhaps you don't really need to know what he's saying exactly. It's just the way he's going at you.
This is his 47th game in charge, 22 wins in that 47. Hubner, who's mopped up nicely. Hernando. Thumbs up from Sandy Walsh. Moriyasu, such a cool, calm customer. Been in charge since 2018, a veritable age in terms of international football management. Risky, miss kicks. Good noise from the Garuda fans away to our right, trying to raise their team. Iraq have equalised against Vietnam. Iraq already qualified as group winners, 6 points for them. They've got the head-to-head victory over Japan. Vietnam, no matter the result today, will finish bottom of the table. Right then, a chance for Ritsu to run. He's got supporters left with Kubo. This is Nakamura. Nakamura, free on the far side players. Ritsu Doan, and a tap-in! Second goal, Ayasi Ueda. Beautifully made, beautifully created. Wonderful execution. 2-0 Japan.
Well, that's come about because Indonesia have changed their approach with their pressing. They were aggressive with their pressing, but it broke. And they were able to find that space in midfield to then play the pass forward. And that's what you have to expect. It's a good ball across the six-yard box. A little bit static there, I think. Hubner, he's just watching. Perhaps he expects Hernando to come for it. He doesn't expect it to go all the way through. But I was just saying that if you change your approach, if you go and press against Japan like that, you need to make sure that your pressing is spot on, that you're winning these balls and that you can't lose them. Because the moment it breaks down, Japan have got the quality to hurt you like that. Space in midfield to exploit. and the quality to really punish you.
Takes an international tally up into double digits now. 10 international goals for the final striker. And Indonesia's response, I think, will be to dig into the substitutes bench. Egy Maulana on the receiving end there from Yuta Nakayama. And Witan is on the bench. Bayankara player. His team are struggling domestically, and he's going to come on for Jakob Sayuri. Witan, another of those players who's had experience abroad as a young player and has developed his game. Good attacking option down the right-hand side, Witan.
Very creative player, Witan Sulaiman.
Suzuki comes a long way. That's a confidence booster for the young man.
He really hasn't had much to do. The protection against the opposition attacks has been so much better. Beautiful bit of distribution. Great take.
Ritsu Doan! Oh, that would have been a postcard, a picture postcard goal.
Wow. That, again, is another move that deserved the goal. Beautiful from Suzuki. Great goalkeeping, nice and positive to come out and claim. And then that distribution, the touch back into Doan. It's just class.
Risky Rido's long ball looks for strike. Well played by Mashida. Little flick forward. First to the ball. Oh, Japan there on the front foot the whole time. Katana's dropped over onto the left-hand side of ostensibly what is a front three. Atate. Space for Kubo. Ritsu's made a great run. Kubo couldn't pick him out. Well played there by Ivar Jenner. The ball instantaneously won back by Japan. Gorgeous. Little futsal triangles. Kubo dispossessed by an old-fashioned centre-half tackle who tries a nutmeg, Jordi Amat. Well, it's a moral victory in a losing cause.
Yeah, here's another look at that move. Brilliant. Hatate with the back heel. Wow. I mean, it just looks so simple, so straightforward. You can see what he was trying to do. Just didn't get the bend, couldn't wrap his foot around it enough to guide it towards that far post. But the move was just back to front so quickly. Great pass from Suzuki, great first touch from Doan. Everything was beautiful up until the finish.
Ueda is on a hat-trick, of course. And Ueda took an inadvertent knock there on the side of the shoulder from Jordi Amat. Amat says, I'm playing on, I didn't touch him. Ball over the top. Rafael will chase into the corner. It's forlorn. Referee is coming to have a word with Ayazi.
Look at that. That's a joke from Ayase Ueda. He's the way he's gone down there. I mean,
two hoisted high. Ferdinand. Nakayama. Classy. Atate's had a really good game. Lovely ball over the top. Ueda on a hat-trick. Good goalkeeping from Hernando. Finds Ritsu. Aikuma He's raided wonderfully down the right-hand side.
Tate has had a very good game. Mentioned that earlier. He's so much energy, such a willing runner.
Arhan. He spent some time playing in the Japanese league with Tokyo. Ueda tries to get through Hubner. He's given 100%. He's given absolutely everything. Justin Hubner.
In Tokyo Verdy now. Don't make the FC Tokyo fans angry. Make that distinction when it comes to Arhan. Hubner coming across, getting that away.
Third corner for Japan.
Understand Arhan is moving to Korea Republic. Play with Suwon.
Yes.
FC.
Oh, lovely ball in. Just gently knocked back in by Nakamura. A little caress of the right foot. And then a little back flick by Kubo. A shimmy inside. And a corner. Three wonderful pieces of individual skill from Japan.
Enjoying themselves out there, I think. Much, much better from Japan.
Five blue shirts. Endo is in there. Machida plays his football in Belgium. Machida was who got the header. Always leaning backwards.
That's this pressing from Japan as well, winning it very quickly. Another turnover.
Ritsu. Maikuma. Nakamura. Again, lovely back flick. Atate helps it over. Keeper gets a touch and is helped out over on the far side by Arhan. I know our match director is trying to get a replay of the second goal in again just to show us it, but Japan just keep coming forward in waves. There's very little opportunity for him to play another long ball. Looks for Ritsu Doan. Ritsu's first touch and a chip just wide.
Yeah, tell you what, they're not going to be short of clips for the highlight reel. Beautiful run. And again, perfect weight on the pass into Ritsu Doan. Showing his awareness, his game intelligence, knew exactly where the goalkeeper Hernando was positioned. Here's another look at it. Great work. Chance after chance after chance for Japan.
Hernando flaps that one away. This time he won't have to worry. Japan 2, Indonesia 0, but highlight reel stuff galore. And then they've got the likes. Have we had Hazoya on there? Deza Maeda. Sano can come on. This could be a long 30 minutes for Indonesia and their supporters. Struik, it's done well. Egy Maulana. Right there, Witan. Who's up in support? Walsh is at the back post. Egy Maulana, can he get across him? He's pulled it back to Ferdinand. Shot over the cross, but much better from Indonesia.
Nice bit of skill from Egy. Show good composure there, sitting down. Japanese defender picking out the right option, I think, with the cutback into Marcelino. Gonna go for the shot first time. Just leaning back as he hit that. Didn't get good control on the effort. Head up straight away. You try and get over the ball in those situations if you can. Just to keep it down.
Oh, Ueda, delicious. Endo helps it on. Kubo, three up in support. Kubo comes right to Nakamura. Nakamura, the overlap once again. Nakayama pulls it back. Ritsu Doan off the line. Hubner does well. And Hubner clears again. And then a foul coming through the back by Tomiyasu. By Machida.
Yeah, so have a look at this overlapping run from Nakayama. Great energy, wonderful work rate. On Nakamura, just holding it up, being patient before releasing Nakayama. Nice and cross towards the back post as well. Good last ditch defending from Hubner.
Late from Egi Maulana. Referee has said play on. Nakayama's down hurt. He's up now on his feet, just off screen to your right. Ritsu Doan. In terms of effort, Indonesia could not be giving more. But they are just being turned backwards, sideways. As Rizky Ridho belts one into the main stand. Solid tackle coming in by Jenna, who hurt himself there. Jenna.
Looks to be okay now, Jenna. It's good to see. He's back up on his feet as we have a look at Strike. No real impact. It's been difficult for him, I think, in this competition to make much of an impact up front. Still very young.
Kim Taeyong. No matter what, Indonesia, with this new crop of European-based players, maybe there's a group of players who could be serving Indonesia in the foreseeable future. That's a good level. Atate is brought down by Maulana. Ritsu is brought down by Hubner. The referee eventually says, OK, enough is enough. A word with Wataru Endo just off to say, listen, I'm in control of things, I'm not giving yellow cards out.
And the captain just going over again just to remind the referee, hey look, we need to try and protect our players. That's what he'll be saying to the referee. There's been a few of those from Indonesia, especially in this second half.
Amat helped by Anando Ari. Maulana gets the free kick. Nakayama plies his trade in Huddersfield. There are glamorous places in the world. Japan do off the ball. People don't really see it, but they're closing down all over the pitch, really compact.
That's been the important thing. I mentioned that word, that counter-pressing. The moment they lose it, they're straight on, switched on to try and win it back again, and that helps to stop those transitions of Indonesia.
Hubner closed down by Ritsu Doan. That's well played out by Arham. There's a flailing arm there. Witan. Down. Ah, it's going to be a yellow card. The arm is just flailing a little bit by Wataru Endo.
Well, he's probably looking for the referee to produce a yellow card to one of Indonesia's players. He's found himself in the book now instead. There's that arm there. There you go. Let's swing across. Well, correct call by the referee. Might wag his finger, but you can see quite clearly on the replay.
First yellow of the tournament for Wataru Endo. Midway through this second half, and changes coming the way of Japan. We are going to see Takumi Minamino and Deza Maeda coming on. Hatate, who's had a really good game, will be replaced by Minamino. And the Celtic striker, Deza Maeda. He'll come on the left-hand side to replace Nakamura.
Deza Maeda. Lots of speed, incredibly hard-working. Gives you absolutely everything, Deza Maeda.
Long throw opportunity for Pratama Arhan. He's come over from the left-hand side to launch this one in. 6 red shirts in and around Ion Suzuki. A couple of players on the edge of the penalty area for the second ball. Arhan, it's very flat. A bit chaotic. And then Mazin. Kubo, it's a 3-on-1 break. Kubo has got Maeda on the far side. Kubo, good goalkeeping. And Ando saw that that was the only real option, I think, for Kubo. And anticipated well.
Yeah, well done by Hernando. I think he's been very positive in his goalkeeping. He's been good at stepping out from his area and also reacting in these situations, stopping danger. Doesn't have to save a shot because he's reading it. He knows where the ball's going to be played into. Nicely positioned there as well. Makes it very difficult for Kubo to actually get it into that angle and try and find Deza Maeda because he kills off that angle into him. Good reading of the game from Hernando. Egi Malana's gone down here. Look at this challenge. Oh, that's a painful one. Minamino is so callous there. Oh, painful one.
Just on the field and just picks on a yellow card. As his trade with Monaco in the French league now, Minamino.
Well, it's good to see him gonna get his move away from Liverpool to Monaco and play some football there, play himself into form. It was a period where he was really sort of struggling with it, with his form, especially for Japan on the international stage. Good to see him getting some regular game time. And he was important for them in that game against Vietnam as well. This is a bad one for Egi.
Egi Molina is being forced off with that one. Big imposing figure, Velkan Bagot. Ipswich Town centre-back. 2 Ipswich centre-backs being represented at this Asian Cup. Cameron Burgess over at Australia. Here's the goal.
Yeah, great movement. Again, that overlapping run. This time around it was... Ritsu Doan. Just getting my Kubos and my Doans mixed up for a second. Ritsu Doan with the overlapping run there, picking up the pass from Nakamura. That's a good ball right across the face of goal. A simple finish in the end.
It's a futsal goal, isn't it?
Yeah. It's just been so mobile. The way they've been moving about in those midfield areas, in those attacking areas, switching up positions.
Well, this is really tough for Egi Molana, 23-year-old.
Yeah, it's actually quite a lot of force in this from Minamino. He's very late. He's right on the top of the foot, on that metatarsal bone.
Hope it's not as bad as it looks for Egi. Elkan Bagot comes on. I'm sure that will mean a change in position. I can't see... Well, no, Elkan has gone in as centre-forward. As this long ball comes up. Interesting. I'm wondering if that's going to be permanent. He's certainly lining up as a big number nine wearing three. You never know, maybe. Toss the ball into the penalty area.
Yeah, I think why not? Just go for it now. Just get the big man up top, see what he can do. Go and challenge for those aerial passes. Look for those flick-ons.
Marcelino. What have we got? Just 17 minutes plus time to add on. We had quite a lengthy stoppage for the injury to Egi Maulana just a few minutes ago. There is Alkenbaga. Alkin's done well, Witan. Marcelino. Baggett makes life difficult. Witan in once again. Well, they're going to give this one a go, I think, Indonesia. If they are going to go out, they're going to go out battling.
Yeah, they certainly are, playing with some really good fighting spirit, going into those challenges. I think at the very least, Shin Tae-yong will be pretty happy with the aggression in the second half. Been a lot quicker with the closing down, quicker going into these challenges and with the pressing.
One of the most impressive sights in football, supporter. Here's a full house at the Senayan when Indonesia fans are in full flow. There's a mini version of it here at the Altamama Stadium. And Hubner's trying to do something, but he's given the ball away. And Tudorne is the man you don't want to give it to. Ueda, who's on the hat-trick, and good goalkeeping from Hernando.
Yeah, again, he's prepared to sweep up Hernando.
He just announced another very healthy attendance, 26,000. Ahmed's got to be careful. He left a foot in there, did the JDT centre-back.
Yeah,
very
late.
On a yellow card.
Very late for Ahmed. The referee is actually pointing him out.
Oh, Witan's done brilliantly. And Witan chasing towards goal. Oh, there's a claim for a handball there by Witan. Assistant has said no. Referee has said no. I'm sure VAR will have a look. Japan, in the meantime, have got possession. 25,000 of the 26,000 are booing.
Yeah, look at this from Indonesia. It's really good to see. Looking to have a strong finish. There's another look at that. Witan, he's injected energy and quality. That's outside the box. Outside the box, anyway.
And he slipped. But we saw yesterday, was it the Australia game? Where you touch the ball like that, it is outside the box, it's not a penalty.
Nothing to look at.
Oh, he didn't get a yellow card for the penalty earlier on, Jordi Amat. I thought he did. Oh, okay.
Oh, it's a bad challenge from Amat. A kick out there. And I say, Ueda, good refereeing, allowed the game to continue. He was pointing him out as the game was being played. Oh, that's another.
That's a foul. That's a yellow card. That's up now.
It's a bad challenge. Really bad challenge from Hubner. Very late. Has the flag gone off for offside as well?
In which case, then, the yellow card will not count, I don't think. Or does it still count? Yeah, he's yellow carding him.
Oh, that was a close one. I think he's actually might be on. Well, we've got the benefit of a replay. Very high, that challenge. It's not a good one at all. Serves the booking.
So free kick. Jordi Amat, a little bit of yellow card confusion. I was sure a yellow was flashed to Jordi Amat after the penalty. But clearly, I was wrong. Back at one of the European-based players, there's continual debate in India and Southeast Asia of the use of players who are what they call heritage players. Got one parent as born in the country, but have been brought up far away. It does cause enormous debate, and particularly in Southeast Asia, Rosh.
Yeah, it certainly does. I mean, it's the way of world football, it's the way the game has been going. Certain nations looking to try and strengthen at the senior international level. And you can, of course you can, but I think it's so important to make sure that while you're doing that, not to forget the development pathways and to make sure that that structure of talent, of players that you have, homegrown, coming through your ranks, is strong as well. Because you want to give them an opportunity, you want to produce players, you can't just forget that development pipeline.
There's a Maeda. Lovely cross. Doan coming in at the back post. Fired just wide by the always dangerous Maikuma. Look at the defending from Arhan on the far post to deny Ritsan Doan, though.
Yeah, well, he's just peeling away Daizen Maeda just to get himself that little bit of space away from Sandy Walsh. And he wants that space so he can push the ball, accelerate and send a cross in. Good bit of defending on the far side from Arhan. Still flick it away. Not a bad effort in the end.
Lovely clean hit, wasn't it? Beautifully caught. Approaching the final 10 minutes. Another change is in the offing for Japan. Yoshi Watanabe is preparing to come on, but not before this throw-in. Looking for Bagot. Suzuki comes for the ball and is impeded by Elkon Bagot. Or was he, Reece Rosenwright?
Yeah, I think he was. Have a look at these changes coming up.
Kubo, he comes off to really good performance from Kubo. And also Tomiyasu. Coming on, we'll have Sano and Watanabe. Kaisho Sano, the Kashima Antlers winger for his fourth cap. Kubo looked close to his impish best. And Tsuyoshi Watanabe, who plays his football in Belgium with Ghent, he comes on for his third international appearance.
Just get a bit more protection in central midfield with Sano coming on just to sit alongside Endo. I think for Moriyasu now is just about trying to just see this out, manage the game. Indonesia looking like they're finishing strong here, which is great to see from their point of view. Japan just wanting to make absolutely sure that they have solidity in central midfield.
Indonesia is close to the Japan players as Reece Rosenwright and Des Korkil are in the commentary box clashing with each other.
That's all right.
10 minutes to go. Indonesia can be proud, as in the first half, that they've kept the score down and they're still going and they're still ostensibly in the game. Japan have played well, haven't got the goals perhaps that they deserve. There's a Maeda, lovely ball, just drops like a little 9-iron. Nakayama's had a very good game at left back. Endo. Iraq lead Vietnam by 2-1. Iraq looking to go through with a perfect performance. Ritsu. One back. Marcelino. He's done well. Looks for Witan. '81 was the last time Indonesia beat Japan in a football match. To be fair, they have only played three times since then, not once this century. A rare meeting of these two nations. It's gone according to the FIFA rankings. Indonesia, 144 in the world. I've been brave, I've given it their all. Minamimo closes down on Hernando Ari. Rido. Endo. A little bit loose, but Ritsu Doan finds Minamino. Looks for Ueda. He's got Maeda either side of him and goes for the shot from 30 yards. Sandy Walsh and Maeda being told off just to make sure that there's no afters. Saw his goalkeeper off his line, trying to take advantage, and another change. Really good performance by Richard Doan, arguably man of the match performance. His replacement is going to be Junya Ito. Reams winger started the two previous games. Japan have got such strength in depth, none of these substitutions in any way, shape or form have weakened the starting 11. So Ito on for Doan. Sandy Walsh. Marcelino plays it back to Rido. Well, that's not a great ball. Fernando apologises to Rido. It's unnecessary pressure. Brave performance by Indonesia. Ivar Jenner in the middle of the park with Ferdinand, Marcelino Ferdinand. They've worked terrifically hard, but Japan just so good in possession, so good at winning the ball back. As it stands, Iraq will be top of the group with 9 points, Japan second with 6, Indonesia third with 3. But there's a chance if they can get it into Ueda. Ueda's on a hat-trick. Ueda! And it's in. Off the underside of the bar. Risky Rido might have come off him. Might go down as an own goal. Ueda will try to claim the hat-trick.
Goal!
It's a fast break. Ito is onside. First time ball, Ueda gets the first shot in. It's come off Hoedema. That will go down as an own goal, which is hard for Justin Hoedema. Off the underside of the bar. Ueda will try to claim a hat-trick, but Hoedema, I think, will be credited with the OG. It's no less than Japan deserve. They make a change. Struck is off. And Dimas Drajad comes on. They're checking the goal. I think the only thing they can be checking the goal for is the original ball into Junya Ito over on the far side, but he looked to be onside. Indeed, the check is over. And Japan have the three-goal lead. For Hajime Moriyasu, this has been perfect. He's been able to rest his potential starters. He's been able to have a look at all of his squad. Just about everybody's been given a game. Here is Watanabe. They've scored three goals. Also on is Ricky Kamboya. Jenna looks absolutely shattered. Jenna. Jenna still working hard. Indonesia still working hard. There's Hoedema. Arhan. Is there a consolation as we go into the first of 6 minutes of time added on? Elkin Baggett will try to make a nuisance of himself. A whole scrum of players as Arhan's ball comes in. And it comes to the back post and it's smuggled in by Sandy Walsh. First international goal for the Mechelen defender. And Indonesia do indeed have their consolation. The long ball eventually causes real problems, and Walsh, available at the far post, smuggles it via the gloves of Suzuki. Nice calm finish from Sandy Walsh. Japan deserve the three goals. Indonesia deserve the consolation. Here's the decision for the Japan onside goal. Junya Ito just held onside by Jody Amat. Then it was Ueda, and unlucky for Hoedema that it comes off him as he tries to block and in off the underside of the bar. Well played, Indonesia. They deserve that. doesn't affect the standings. You never know, though, that goal might come into play as other results come into play tomorrow. Indonesia will end the group on 3 points, but at the moment with a -3 goal difference. They'll be third in the group. It will be above China, but it will be a China and Indonesia who miss out. Only from the six groups, the top two teams go through. In this group, that is Iraq and Japan. And the four best third place teams will make up the rest of the round of 16. Vietnam, I'm told, have just equalised. So 2-2, Vietnam versus Iraq. So Iraq will not be perfect. Vietnam will not be pointless. Quang Hai for Vietnam. Well played by Ivar Jenner. Marcelino hauled down by Nakayama. Indonesia chasing a second here. Jordi Amat not pleased that there's no card for that foul. The second goal could make a difference. Bagot coming in at the far post and a clear push there on the impressive Seya Maikuma. Wasn't a sophisticated approach, but it's an approach that helped Indonesia get their consolation through Sandy Walsh in injury time. Jenner, tug back. Bagot again. Gets a flick to it. He wants a corner. He's not going to get one. You can see there, he towers over Kamis Almari. That's why they're aiming for him. Shin Tae-yong can look at his team with a real amount of pride. Moriyasu, job done for them in getting to the round of 16. Now the tournament really starts. Maeda closes. Nervy moment for Anandawari. Just the pace of the game that Japan play. You don't witness that in the domestic league in Indonesia, where the likes of Anando and Rizky play. Japan have won this one by 3-1. A brace of goals by Ayase Ueda. First, a penalty. Second, a lovely conversion after a sweet move early in the second half. He forced an own goal for the unfortunate Justin Hubner to make it 3-0 in the 89th minute. Sandy Walsh got one. A consolation for Indonesia that might still have some significance, but it's finished here at the Altamama Stadium as Japan 3, Indonesia 1. Many changes for Japan. They did what they had to do. They got the boost of the early goal. They dominated. They played some scintillating football. They really enjoyed the game. Paul Suzuki. He had a relatively quiet game, but still picked the ball up off the back of his net. Jody Amat has a word with the referee, conceding a very early penalty. The Indonesia captain still not thrilled about that decision. But Indonesia, it's growth for them. It's all about incremental improvements for Shin Tae-yong and his team. As the two coaches have a good word with each other, a good competitive game, good competitive spirit. Japan were always expected to go through. They are the giants of Asian football, and they have taken their place in the round of 16. Indonesia have to wait to see if their efforts and that win against Vietnam is going to be enough for them. Pride in defeat for Indonesia. Well played by Japan. They will come second in the group, but now the real business starts for them as they try to take the Asian Cup for the fifth time. It's finished here at the Altamama Stadium of Japan 3, Indonesia 1.
This is what it means.